Okay, so my name is Anuja and my colleague's name is Vasant over here. We are demonstrating the active, the name of the project that we are demonstrating over here is the active BLE. The main aim of this project is to detect the tamper of the overhead bins of an aircraft. So whenever the aircraft, when it is grounded for some amount of hours and when it is into the hangar mode, it has been found that some of the tamper is happening with the overhead bins into of that aircraft. So we are basically, the main aim of this project is to demonstrate the tampering or to detect the tampering of the overhead bins of an aircraft. So over here I have, so this is the prototype of the latches which will be there into the overhead bins. This is the general architecture and you can see on both the sides of the aircraft we have placed the latches as well as the sensors also are incorporated over here. So different latches will have a different type of sensors over here. So so now we have an app over here which will control the, these are the app and this will control the working of the latches. So we have four buttons over here, that is arm, disarm, status and config button. So for now I am issuing the arm command. My colleague is issuing the arm command for 1 minute and So when it is issuing the arm command, you can see the communication is happening with the Bluetooth low energy packet. So these packets are being transferred to your nodes and the nodes are also in the scanning mode. They will be scanning and they will also be sending the acknowledgement packets. So as you can see, these three of the nodes have been responded as an active. So now for 1 minute, these three nodes are in active mode. So my colleague will go and tamper one of the nodes. So now this tampering is can be only done when your nodes are into the active mode. And this is the general architecture for my node. So in this architecture we have this NRF 52832 board, we have the gateway board and we have the piezo sensor board. So depend upon what type of sensor you are using, this board will change, rest of it will remain the same. This is a CRC 2032 220 mAh 3 volt battery which is sufficient enough to power the whole system. And based upon the sensor which you are using, it will suffice for 10 years of lifetime. So I have three different type of sensors over here. One is your capacitive touch sensor, one is your switch, and second is your the piezo based sensor. So all this lifetimes, so the lifetime for these sensors is different. So piezo sensor can suffice for a 12 years of lifetime and a capacitive can suffice for a 7 years of lifetime. So and this is a BLE antenna which is also capable of doing the communication till the 70 meters of it. So now I am going to issue, now let's check whether the status of all the nodes has been there or not. So this is the status, he will issue the status node, status command. So in the status command also first we will get the acknowledgements from the packets and then we will issue one more command to know whether they have been tampered or not. So now you can see the acknowledgements of all the three packets have come over here. Now my colleague will issue all nodes info. So this is one command where I am going to get the information of all the nodes and it can shows that he has tampered R2. So R2 has been shown as tampered and the nodes which are not tampered will shown as not tampered. So R1 was shown as non-tampered. So in this way it is easier for him also, because now the present scenario they were going and manually checking each of the bins. So this become tedious when there are now more number of bins into an aircraft. And now with this kind of a solution that we have proposed over here, so he don't need to go and check each of this latches. He can only know that he knows a particular latch that R2 has been tampered, so he can just go to R2 and do further information things. We also have one more logs file to it. So this logs also shows the timestamp at which the whole of this system was been tampered at. So this file can also be a shareable file. Then there are other modes also, shareable file. Then there are other modes also which is called as a disarm mode. So these are disarm mode. So this is the other modes which are called as disarm and status config mode. In the disarm mode, the flight will be already in operation, so you don't need to worry more about the tamper and all. And config mode is the only mode where we are using the next, for the next session of checking, security check, we will be using a different set of keys. So that's all about that.